trucks, went to these construction sites, gave them glucose, biscuit and chai. Believe me, there are like 50-60 people who want to come and sit there. So really, women with their children and you know, some people come and sit there. They give them glucose, biscuit and chai, and they, you just teach them about these flip charts. How, and flip charts have nothing to do with the toilets. It's about hygiene on site. And how dirty, how you get malaria and dengue, and how you must keep your environment clean, how important is menstrual hygiene, how important is not to chuck your you know, prophylactics or whatever into the toilet, how to keep it clean, how to keep your surrounding. All that was taught to them. No? And at every instance, we had, okay, for you, for your facility, so that in this 20 minutes, if you want to use this toilet over here, you can use this toilet at any given time. This is how clean toilet should be. So people would use that in their intrigue to use it. We are talking about hygiene, and then what happened is the local Mukadam supervisor would go and tell his engineer. Engineer would tell his superior, and said, "Sir, wo shramik ka ek bahut acha toilet hai. Hum log ka uska ye program kiya tha, un logon ne CSR apna bahut acha tha. Fit apne agar site pe lagaya, to hamara log ka ye bahut acha kaam hoga." So morale, mentality, all that will improve. So we used a different style to really market a product. We did use the conventional system of marketing of giving brochures and giving catalogs, and because the end user was the common man. And to reach the common man, the best form of advertising was mouth-to-mouth publicity and direct sort of sample survey, sample usage. So we started doing that, and that has become a standard system for us now, and we have made that into a standard model for promoting our social enterprise. So it is a standard model for, and we do it through various agencies, through our company, and we promote this all over the country. So you will, on the construction side, very common to see glucose, biscuit and chai. Nothing has changed, just that the quality of the flip chart has gotten better. You know, we use, you know, we better sort of, we do have a few pamphlets and stuff to distribute to people. We have coupon system, all kind of things. We've sort of innovated a bit in that. But yes, the style of marketing has been very different.
Like, you said you have a GPS on your vehicle, like, you know, and if the driver is good and all, do you have any kind of a punishment or something like that? How do you handle that?
Yeah, you need to find them to a website. You cannot, the thing is that, first of all, there are three people, you know, it's not very easy to find good drivers anyway. So, it's like a known devil is better than a unknown angel. So what you do is that you somehow manage within the thing. Yes, but if his mistake, whatever he does, is very grave, then of course you ask him to leave. But otherwise, you know, you find him, and then he doesn't do it for some time. Then again, he'll end up doing it. But it's like an honest thief. I mean, you can't hang him for that. You can't give him to the cops for that. And I mean, it's a done thing. You have to sort of be a little lenient to it. Although it's not very good, but you have to be lenient. Yeah. You have to sort of, you know, sort of not look at it with that much of
that seriousness.
Yeah, unless, like I said, if it's very grave. I mean, if he does like a very serious mistake, if he backs up the truck or gets drunk or something, we don't allow it. If a person comes drunk for work or something like that, or if he goes and, you know, bashes up somebody and, you know, all these kind of things, then of course he's immediately asked to leave. But things like this, you have to sort of get a little flexible. You can't really have hard and fast, you know, you can't be so stringent about it. Although you have GPS, ultimately you are dealing with humans. And it's the most difficult thing to find, most difficult to deal with, are people. And my biggest problem is human talent. You know, human talent is the most difficult to get. You can, machines, technology, paradigm shift, all that, everything you can do. Dealing with people, you know, is the most difficult thing. And the more senior the people, the more difficult it gets to deal with them. People who are, you know, not very educated, you know, they understand much easier than people who are very, very educated and are very senior positions. They are more difficult to talk to.
There are a lot of conditions. What is happening is education over a period of time used a lot of programs, the do's and the don'ts. So, your mind ka conditioning ho jata hai. So, with this conditioning, what is happening is that there is something in reality. So, when he's too educated or too much of conditioning is there, we'll try and see what are those things that he has learned. छोटा सा लड़का रहेगा जो अनपढ़ रहेगा वो जाके आग बुझा देगा बट इफ इज एजुकेटेड पर्सन यू मे थिंक सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज कंडीशनिंग इज व्हाट द मूव इज इफ यू कैन हैव अ सिस्टम वेयर वी कैन डीकंडीशन ह्यूमन माइंड एंड अगेन कंडीशनिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड नहीं तो आप काम नहीं कर पाओगे एवरीडे इफ यू कैन कंडीशन एंड एवरीडे नाइट इफ यू कैन डीकंडीशन इट्स अ वेरी गुड देन टुमारो मॉर्निंग यू लुक एट अ प्रॉब्लम फ्रेशली फ्रेश क्या हो जाता है पास्ट नॉलेज समटाइम्स बिकम्स अ बर्डन फॉर यू टू ऑपरेट दिस एंड एज ही सेड